With the recent success of Chang'e 4 landing on the far side of the moon and sending back the first pictures ever from there, we cannot stop wondering what China has planned next. How far do the Chinese ambitions for the moon reach?
Yes, and where will the first Chinese astronauts, I mean taikonauts, land on the moon, and will they set up a permanent base there? And first and foremost, will they maybe conquer the whole moon? That and more on this episode of Sci-Fi Instinct!
Warning, this episode contains some over-the-top conspiracy theory joke and resembles three persons and events purely coincidental. If however you assume I feel offended by these jokes, then you clearly have no sense of humor and should consult a physician, psychologist, comedian, better yet, free best of alcohol.
In so many sci-fi movies, humanity has set up a permanent base on the moon. You can watch our previous video on the American Lisa moon base plans from the Apollo era, which unfortunately never came to pass. If you look at some sci-fi moon bases, there's not a single one that foresees a future Chinese moon base.
It almost seems as if everyone is taken by surprise with China's moon ambitions and the incredible fast pace with which China is catching up in space. So will China land a man on the moon soon? And will they repeat the error of the Americans of not setting up a permanent base? Or will they learn from their mistakes and immediately set up a permanent lunar colony?
In the matter of only a few decades, China went from a backwards communist economy with underdeveloped cities, now to a state-controlled capitalistic superpower with cyberpunk-looking cities straight out of Blade Runner.
In space, however, for a long time, there were only the Americans and the Soviets dominating human spaceflight. Only 17 years ago, in 2002, there never had been a Chinese taikonaut to space ever. So China was basically in 2002, where the Soviet Union was in 1960. They basically were lagging behind 40 years. Chinese space ambitions, however, began already during that era of the space race, when Mao himself announced in 1973 Project 714 that was planned to bring Chinese astronauts into space by 1973. However, due to the poor Chinese economy of that era, those plans never came to fruition.
Then, in 1986, Project 863 was announced, which would put humans into space and also envisioned the construction of a space station. In 1992 then, this project was transformed to Project 921, also known as Shenzhou.
What?
Shenzhou?
Wait, is there a logic to these numbers? Project 921, 863, 714, with the ratio of 9 ratio, the ratio. That's not it, no.
No, it has to be the sum.
It must be the sum. The sum, wait, the sum, 921 plus 863 plus 921 plus 863 plus 9863 plus 714 is 2498. 2 plus 4 plus 9 plus 8 is 23. I knew it, 23. The Illuminati! They are in league with China! They are in league with China and want to take over the world!
It took another decade until the plans were realized, and then in 2003, the first Chinese astronaut, Yang Liwei, was sent into space by China. And suddenly, China ascended into the illustrious club of nations with their own human spaceflight program. Since then, China has sent taikonauts multiple times into space with their Shenzhou program, and even had their first space station in 2011.
But as we all know, Tiangong 1 burned up as it re-entered the atmosphere in 2018 together with our favorite actress Sandra Bullock. Thanks China, thanks for saving Sandra Bullock so that we can enjoy many more wonderful movies with her. Ooh.
But even before Tiangong, the Chinese had set the sight towards the moon. Now, Tiangong 2 is planned and scheduled to launch sometime between 2021 and 2022. Chang'e 1 and 2 were launched 2007 and 2010 respectively, but they only orbited the moon. It wasn't until 2013 that the famous Chang'e 3 mission was conducted.
This was not only the first time that China landed an unmanned probe on the moon, but it was the first mission back to the surface of the moon since the Soviet probe Luna 24 in 1976, while Chang'e 3, I hope I pronounced it right, consisted of a lander, and a small rover called Yutu, which would detach from the lander and drive around a bit on the surface. Here we can see Yutu at a Chinese technology exhibition. Wait, what is that? Is that a... No, it can't be. Is that a... And that's 224-176. Stop. Center and pull back. And hence 34-36. Stop. And hence 224-276. Give me a hard copy right there. But don't worry, this is surely only a joke with a mushroom cloud exploding and destroying Europe. I mean, that's a perfectly normal joke on a
it's
Chinese
only a
exhibition.
Joke, no worry. No worry.
Only a joke, right? Okay, look, everything fine. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. You really believe that it's a joke? And now, only a few days ago, on the 3rd of January 2019, Chang'e 4 landed on the far side of the moon. The spacecraft is very similar to Chang'e 3. It consists of a lander, together with a small rover, that detached from the lander. However, what's really astounding here is the communication with mission control, because a direct communication is not possible when landing on the far side, since the moon would obstruct a direct communication.
Therefore, the data is transmitted via the Queqiao, of course, relay satellite. A truly astounding technological feat that has never been done before. However, one question remains. Why landing on the far side of the moon in the first place? What is there so interesting to land on the far side? There surely must be something interesting there. Something secret, something they don't want us to know. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Who has been hiding there? I don't want to say the word, it's an evil word, but they have been hiding there since 1945. Yes, 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 you know exactly what I'm talking about. Since 1945 they have been hiding there, even Nazis. Yes, the Nazis have been hiding there.
Of course.
Yes, yes, and that's why the Chinese want to land there and unite forces with Nazis, and then they will become the evil Nazi communists from outer space. Okay, that one, I'm sorry, but that Nazi joke had to be. It's moon, far side of the moon, I had to do it, sorry. I couldn't resist. No, moon Nazi is not funny. Communist Nazi is not funny.
They don't like it here in Germany.
Okay, then I won't do it again. Of course I will. So what are the future plans for Chinese moon exploration? When will we finally see the first taikonauts landing on the moon? It's kind of an open secret that the Chinese space agency is already kind of working on a manned lunar exploration and already preparing.
For example, in 2008, a Chinese manned lunar rover concept was shown to the public. And last but not least, the symbol of the Chinese lunar space program is quite clear. The two footsteps symbolize the ultimate goal of Chinese lunar ambitions. First, a man landing on the moon, and then setting up a permanent lunar colony.
We think that it is quite realistic that the first Chinese manned lunar landing on the moon will take place in the early 2030s, maybe as early as 2030, and then setting up a permanent base shortly afterwards. Actually, early engine tests of the heavy lift rocket that will bring Chinese taikonauts to the moon are already underway.
The rock is called Chang'e 9 or Long March 9 and will have a quite formidable lift capacity of 140 tons to low Earth orbit, 50 tons to lunar transfer orbit, and 44 tons to Mars. Similar to Saturn V, the first maiden flight of Long March 9 is planned for 2028. And after 1 to 2 years of testing, we think that the manned lunar landing will be the first mission that this rocket will be used for.
But who will be back on the moon first in this new space race? The Chinese or the Americans with SpaceX? Well, this is difficult to say, but since the SpaceX system is fully reusable, I think SpaceX will have an advantage because the SpaceX system is simply cheaper and more efficient than the non-reusable Long March 9 of the Chinese. SpaceX might, however, still have the advantage because they have a strict timetable and they planned already the first round trip around the moon for the year 2023 with Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa on board. And we think that a manned lunar landing with the SpaceX Super Heavy Starship system might already be possible in the late 2020s.
So SpaceX might be a little bit faster than the Chinese, but we cannot say it definitely. Depends of course also on who would want to make use of the SpaceX launch system. Maybe NASA would like to charter the spaceship and send some of their own people up as soon as possible, just to get back to the moon before the Chinese.
And there's a reason why I don't mention NASA's space launch system. Because I think it is inferior to SpaceX's system in every conceivable way. First of all, it has a lower LEO capacity, then it is not reusable and is far more expensive because of that. And NASA is subject to changing governments, where programs get shifted all the time and programs get cancelled. For example, look at the Constellation program, which was cancelled in 2010. It was supposed to bring people to the moon by 2019. So that's why I think the space launch system would actually never bring astronauts to the moon. I think at some point NASA will switch to SpaceX system and charter SpaceX rockets to fly their astronauts to the moon. Similar of how astronauts will soon fly with the Dragon capsule and the Falcon 9 SpaceX system to the International Space Station.
One thing is for certain, however. This time, the astronauts and the taikonauts will set up permanent lunar manned colonies in order to make humanity a multi-planetary species.
Finally!
With the next goal, of course, being Mars. Thank you so much for watching us today, and we hope you liked our episode on the Chinese lunar program.
So leave us a comment in the comment section on who you think will be the first back on the moon, the Chinese, or SpaceX, or maybe someone who we forgot, who knows? Maybe the Romanians, or the Bulgarians, or the Pakistani, who knows, right?
The Europeans, probably?
The Europeans, no. No. No chance. No chance.
And if you're new to this channel, and if you like our style of presenting, then we would be very happy if you would subscribe.
So see you the next time on Sci-Fi Instinct!
再见!
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 Tschüss! Ciao!
Tschüss!
Wiedersehen!
Bye-bye!